Hi everybody, thanks for tuning into my video. Andrew here. I've had a lot of interest on my first video of the DIY TV lift project, so I thought I'd share some video I made during the construction process. This is not meant to be a full step-by-step how-to video, but more to show you how I went about it and hopefully to inspire you to go and make something for yourself. I've arranged the video into five parts. Initial planning, testing in position and fitting the TV, final assembly, the storage box, and enhancements and final thoughts. So if one area is of more interest to you, feel free to go straight to that video. It turned out to be a lot longer project than what I thought it would, as is always the case, I guess. And it also turned out to be much dearer than what I thought. I think the cheapest thing was buying the TV. The main criteria for the TV lift was that it had to be strong enough to move a 55-inch LCD TV up and out of the way into the roof area of the pergola. The TV had to be viewable from both the pergola side and from the swimming pool. The TV had to be stored in a box to keep it out of the dust and weather as much as possible. And it had to have remote control with automated functions so that a press of the remote control would carry out a sequence of movements like opening the storage box, lowering the TV, swiveling the TV, and then tilting the TV. I wanted to incorporate this into a Harmony remote, which would also integrate the normal TV functions. I started getting my thoughts together by playing with some motors. In this case, it's a windscreen wiper motor that I intended to use for the swivel control. I had to get an idea of how much current it used and how much power it had to turn the TV. While the motor had to be strong enough to turn the TV, I didn't want it too strong so that it would hurt somebody if they were struck by the TV. So the wiper motor seems to be just about the right size. Next, I did a number of scale drawings just by hand on graph paper, because I'm old school, just to work out the geometry and to see what the sizing was needed for the TV that I'd chosen. One of the biggest considerations for the project was how I was going to raise and lower the TV. I ended up using a linear actuator, which after a fair bit of experimentation worked okay. You can imagine that lifting a TV at arm's length is way, way harder than just trying to lift it up close to your body. So there's a lot of extra strain on the system there. And as you can see there, I used bricks and so forth there just to test the load during the initial stages of experimentation. So the arm had to be strong enough to lift the TV, but I also had to incorporate a swivel function so the TV could turn around. I did this using two pieces of pipe with a smaller diameter pipe fitting within the larger one. No bearings were used, but it seems to be okay for the purpose that I'm using it for. I made a simple coupling to connect the swivel shaft to the windscreen wiper motor. And then that's when I started to experiment with speed control units to slow it down. You've probably gathered by now that we can't have the swivel going 360 degrees because of all the cables from the TV and the tilt actuator. So this is just experimentation at this stage, but later on I added some stops to have a defined range of swivel. This is the
prototype of a automated TV bracket that I'm making for my pergola, and the TV will bolt there to the plate. It's got a little linear actuator there to tilt the TV down, the main actuator there to swing it down, and a 12 volt motor to pivot the TV around 180 degrees so we can see it from the other side where the pool is. And it's all controlled by this little microcontroller from Splat Controls in Australia. Power supply, 12 volts, and just some buttons there just so I can do some testing. So we'll press the first one, we'll see how we go. Okay, so I've got temporarily another actuator there which will be opening the cover for the box that the TV goes on. So that's got to go up and make that proc switch activate first. Then the TV starts lowering. Once the TV is down or in the down position, it will tilt. I hope. Lovely. So once the TV's down in position, the cover will close. Just the theory anyway, hope it works. And that's it for position one. Okay, we're going to try the other position now. So that's the middle button. The yellow button there is to close it. Okay, so it's tilted around. That's not right. Okay, now we're going to try the other position, which is the middle button there. So the TV is facing around the other direction. So we press that. The open cover actuator is working. As soon as it hits the top limit switch there, the main arm should start lowering with a bit of luck. Yes, there we go. It's all controllable by time on the program that I'm writing at this stage, so it probably needs some fine tuning. So swinging down, when it's down, it should pivot around 180 degrees and then tilt. Beautiful. It's gone through that sequence, so it's closing the cover again now. Well, it will once I've built the thing. And that's that sequence finished. So we press the last button now to raise it. Just to reverse there, so it's tilting up. And swing back around. Oh, sorry, that right up there is going first. Tilting up. Swing around. And back up. So for the swing motor there, there's two limit switches there, just to detect each side of the 180 degree swing. I'm just using a little relay board at the moment. I'm not sure whether that'll be used in the final unit. That's a little motor speed controller I got off eBay. I needed that for this motor here, this wing motor, because it was going too fast. So you know, for about $4 delivered, it works pretty well. The controller that I've mentioned is really cool. First time I've used one. You could use an Arduino for this. There's no problem there. So I'll just stop it running. This is a little program that I'm writing. It's quite simple. In fact, I think it's a lot more straightforward than writing Arduino code. So, but anyway, still learning, and it's working.
So before I could do the initial testing, I had to sketch out what the circuit was going to be. So I just did that by hand on paper, and eventually I drew it up properly, which you'll see in the last video. The other important step in relation to the electronics was to firstly do an I/O table for the microcontroller. This just helps you articulate what I/O is needed for the project, and makes it a lot easier when you're writing the program.